not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold, but with the precious blood of Christ as of a lamb without blemish, without spot.
Mary will join her beloved on their We were both so love struck, we hardly knew what to do with ourselves. In fact, it was the day after Mary and I became engaged, and what a day. I was just a carpenter with a lot of hopes, dreams, and Mary, she still is. She's the most beautiful girl in all of Galilee. Of all the young men that wanted her hand in marriage, I was somehow the one she chose. She was so perfect. Like a lily on a spring morning. Mary, there you are, my bride-to-be. How have you been? It's been so long since I've seen you.
A whole evening and a morning since we saw each other. One day.
One day less for us to wait.
I can't believe it. I just feel like I'm just going to wake up and I'm going to find it's all a dream.
Me too. You know, Mary, I've never loved anyone as much as I love you.
I love you too, Joseph. And we're going to have such a wonderful life together.
The best. You know, in fact, I've already decided that in the next 12 months, I'm going to build you a house. It's going to be the most beautiful house in all of Galilee.
I don't deserve you, Joseph.
No, I'm the one that doesn't deserve you.
Oh, I must go now. I keep telling myself that time is going to pass quickly, but it seems so long. Do you think time is going to pass quickly?
I think it will seem like moments. Now, you go home and sleep well. I promise you I will use every one of those moments to prepare you a wonderful place where you, my love, will dwell with me.
Thank you.
an angelic messenger come to me? And the angel said that he will be great, and he'll be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord will give him the throne of his father David and his kingdom. There will be no end. But how can this be? And why should he come to me? What do I tell Father? What do I tell Tina Joseph?
She didn't tell anyone for a time. She kept the things the angel told her. She pondered them in her heart. When I learned, when I knew she was with child, many things, all sorts of things were torturing my mind. I had no peace about me. The only thing I could think to do was just end our marriage plans, not tell anybody why. But then the dream came. God sent his angel to tell me his will. I was sleeping. He said that what Mary spoke was true, that this was back a miracle child sent from God. I was so humbled by the dream. Now Mary and I both knew what God had planned for us. And we knew we were both pure. So we knew this truly had to be a miracle. But we also knew what people would say. We knew they would talk. Who could believe such a thing? We knew the rumors would begin. There was very little chance of anyone really believing our story. But these were the simple facts. Mary was a child, and there was no earthly father. This was a child that God himself had placed within Mary's body, and God himself had revealed it all to us. Our son would be the newborn Lamb of God, the Christ child, the Messiah, the Savior of the world. This little one, God in the flesh, would be born into our home. A mighty king. Emmanuel. God with us. The Lamb of God who would come to take away the sins of the world.
I forbid you to speak!
I can just hear what the villagers will say.
when we try to tell of your story, the bright hopes that you have. Oh.
Mary, please don't put us through this. It is too much to bear.
I'm telling you the truth. God placed this child within me. He told me that he's going to be the Messiah. My Messiah and your Messiah.
Blasphemy! That is blasphemy against God. How dare you? How dare you betray all that we have blessed you with? You betray our love, you betray our family, and you betray our faith. Oh, dear God, how could you allow us to be, after all the years we've labored to be so faithful? What of yourself, Eli? What kind of father are you?
Months to follow wouldn't get any easier for either of us. There was no resolution. Everywhere she went, Mary faced people who refused to believe. And all we could do was accept it all in faith. It's part of God's plan. But 9 months after the angel first appeared to us, we were required to journey to Bethlehem during the time that Mary was due to give birth. Caesar had made a decree that every man should return with his family to his hometown to be counted and taxed. Over the months, Mary's mother actually began to get accustomed to the idea of being a young grandmother. In fact, she seemed to anticipate the birth. Though she was afraid to admit it in front of Eli, I even think that she believed the message of the angel. Eli, he was a totally different story. Even up until the moments before we left, Mary tried to win back the father's heart.
And Mary, do be sure to stay on that donkey. A woman great with child should not walk on such a long journey. And you make sure that you let Joseph know how you're feeling and if you need anything. And by all means, make sure you stay warm. Last thing you need in your condition is to catch a cold. And you keep that grandbaby of mine warm. And whatever you do, you stop and you rest often. Don't you push yourself too hard. A woman in your condition.
Okay, Mother, I will. You're pacing around this house like you're the one expecting the baby. Everything's going to be fine. It's all in our Heavenly Father's hands.
Yes, I know, Mary.
Excuse me, Mary. We are burning daylight. We have got to get going. I'll wait outside, okay?
Oh, and Joseph, just a few more things for the donkey. Just be sure to save a place for Mary.
Father, it's time for us to leave.
Ride carefully.
The baby will probably be warm while we're away. And I'm sorry you all won't be there. Well, I guess I better go.
Mary?
Yes, Father?
Mary, I know this has been a difficult 9 months for you. It has been that way for all of us. We've all felt the pains of adjusting when life doesn't do what you expected it to. And I know I've been, well, I guess I will be harsh. Uncaring, stubborn, even mean at times. You can stop me at any time.
We're not finished yet.
I want you to know that before you got, well, even though a lot of things have changed, there are some things that have not. Mary, you still are my daughter, and I want you to know that I do still love you. And I always will. And your baby, this little one, will be my granddaughter or my grandson. And I want you to know that I will love this child. And I will be the best grandpa I'm able to be.
Thank you, Father. But this child will be a son. He will be your grandson. And his name will be Jesus.
Mary, must you continue even unto these last moments with us? I'm trying to tell you I cannot accept your story. It's been a long 6 months of turmoil. But your mother and I, we understand. You and Joseph are married now. You did what was the respectable thing to do. And now it's up to us to put the past behind us and get on with our lives. And what of this grandchild? What kind of life is he going to have if his mother is convinced that he's the Messiah? Rachel, please tell her. We've tried to understand.
You have tried nothing, Eli. You have only tried to save your own reputation amongst the townspeople and in the temple. You have thought of only yourself these last 6 months. Has it ever occurred to you, even for a moment, that her story might be true?
True?
Yes, true. Have you considered that your daughter has never done anything remotely rebellious? Has it occurred to you that while we have questioned her for the last 6 months, she has never faltered in her love for us? Has it occurred to you that while the townspeople have blamed and rejected her, she has not rejected the God that you taught her to love? Eli, you know the prophecies. Read them again for yourself. I only know this. I choose to believe.
God showed him. in a matter of moments. The spotless Lamb of God suddenly appeared to him in the scriptures as he read the prophet Isaiah.
Can this be? Isaiah writes, "Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel." A virgin, a pure, innocent young girl. Mother, Rachel, come here quickly.
What is it, Eli?
Look at this, the prophecies. Isaiah says it here. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son. A virgin, a son, somebody's grandson. And look over here. He writes again. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor,
Amen.
The Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Rachel, her story is true. Oh, what a fool I have been. This child, this grandson that God has placed in Mary's womb, this child is God. God with us, and God in the flesh. And look where he must be born. The prophet Micah says, "But thou, Bethlehem, out of thee shall he come forth unto me, who is to be ruler in Israel, whose goings forth have been from of old, from everlasting." Rachel, don't just stand there. Pack the bags. My grandson, I mean the Savior, is going to be born in Bethlehem. Oh, Rachel. I know it's taken me a while, but I too choose to believe.
I choose to believe. My doubts have passed away. I'll trust him every day and choose to believe. The prophets of old foretold the coming King, so I'll rejoice and sing. I choose to believe.
Fields and lakes, in fields and lakes.
journey to Bethlehem was so difficult. There was just so many crowds. The crowds were just unbearable. Mary was exhausted. The baby was soon to be born. And after hours of searching for just a place to stay, all I could find for her was a stable. But suddenly, it was as though 9 months of ridicule and scorn had just melted away in the presence of God Almighty. God with us in the form of a newborn baby, born in a manger.
Yeah.
But somehow, it just seemed natural to me that there were sheep. Soft, tender, gently bleating sheep on the same straw where the Lamb of God was born.
Mary, my gentle little girl from Galilee. Please forgive a foolish man.
Father, may I introduce you to Jesus? In addition to being your grandson, he is the savior of all who place their trust in him.
Thank you.
strength and honor and glory and blessing. And every creature heard I say, blessing and honor and glory and power be unto him that sitteth upon the throne and unto the Lamb forever and ever.